والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه وبعد. All praises due to Allah. May Allah's peace and blessings be upon His Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. Today, inshallah, we starting our first session in explanation of a beautiful book. الأمثال في القرآن. الأمثال في القرآن. The parables or the examples from the Quran or in the Quran by Imam Ibn al-Qayyim or Ibn Qayyim al-Jawziyya rahimahullah. Inshallah, we will finish this in four sessions. Inshallah, Rabbi Alameen, four sessions, 4 weeks. So we can start, inshallah, the explanation of the sections of Salah and the Siyam from Fiqh, inshallah, Fiqh Muyassar, simplified Fiqh, until Ramadan. We'll start with the Tahara, Wudu, and Salah, Ahkam of Salah, and Jum'ah, if we can, inshallah. And then we will do As-Siyam. So, inshallah, the month of February will be for this book. The month of March, April, until Ramadan, inshallah, May, we'll have the Salah and the Siyam. So, inshallah, يعني, there will be a course for everybody, inshallah, to listen to, recorded after that. This book, inshallah, since it is four sessions only, it will be very mukhtasar. Mukhtasar means very abridged explanation. Just we'll go with the text in Arabic, and I'm going to translate it or give you the approximate translation in English, and we'll do some light ta'liq on it, some light comment. But if there is something that needs to be in depth, we'll just dive in and then we'll come back very quickly. So we're not going to spend much time. But this book can be explained easily in 50 sessions. It can be easily explained in 50 sessions. But we will not take that much. We'll do four or five, inshallah. But four, we'll stick with four, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. First, we'll do a very brief biography of Imam Ibn al-Qayyim. And then we'll start the text right away, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. Who is Ibn al-Qayyim? Sometimes you hear Ibn al-Qayyim, sometimes you hear Ibn Qayyim al-Jawziyya. Both is the same person. Ibn al-Qayyim or Ibn Qayyim al-Jawziyya. And don't mix that with Ibn al-Jawzi. Ibn al-Jawzi is another scholar. يعني. Ibn al-Jawzi is a complete different scholar, da'iyah, muhaddith, all of that, and you know, linguist and all. But Ibn al-Qayyim is an encyclopedia scholar who is the student and for أهل العلم who said يعني ابن تيمية يعني is like his son. في طلب العلم you can be the son of the sheikh that you stayed with all the life, you know, and then you become حفيد of him, like, you know, when we say ابن رجب الحنبلي, he is the حفيد of شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية. Why? Because ابن رجب was the student of ابن القيم, and ابن القيم was the student of Ibn Taymiyyah. So we say that, you know, among student knowledge, you said Ibn Rajab al-Hanbali is like the Hafid, the grandson of Ibn Taymiyyah. Not blood, يعني, but by knowledge. Like, إنما المؤمنون إخوة, there is the Iman relationship, there is the blood relationship, there is the Iman relationship, and there is the ilm relationship. العلم رحم بين أهلي. علم is like the, you know, you have صلة الرحم, you have رحم among the ulama and the people of Quran. They are also attached together. بإذن الله تعالى. So ابن قيم الجوزية. قيم means the principal or the headmaster of the institute. القيم, the man is called القيم. يعني there is an institute and there is أوقاف, you know, endowment, land, and you know, all those projects around the madrasa in Damascus, you know, the madrasa that teaches people the Quran and the ilm, and it has endowment trust around it. So the person who is managing all this property is called what? القيم. And the Al-Jawziyya is the name of that institute, right? Al-Jawziyya is the name of that institute. And he is Qayyim al-Jawziyya, means he is the headmaster of that institute. So Ibn al-Qayyim means his son, the son of that. And he was a scholar too, his father. What's his name? Abu Abdullah, that's his kunya. Abu Abdullah, Muhammad ibn Abi Bakr ibn Ayyub ibn Sa'ad. Shamsuddin, that is his laqab, that's his title. Ibn Qayyim al-Jawziyya أو Ibn al-Qayyim رحمه الله. He died in the year 751 of Hijra of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. 751 of Hijra. He was born 691 and he died 751 of Hijra, which is equal to 1292 to 1350, you know, after Christ. Muhammad ibn Abi Bakr ibn Ayyub ibn Sa'ad, الزرعي الدمشقي أبو عبد الله شمس الدين. And he is a great encyclopedia scholar. He is a jurist, he is a muhaddith, he is a scholar of Quran and the Qiraat and the Tafsir. He is someone of the suluk, alim of the suluk, means the behavior and the conduct, softener of the heart. He is a great scholar of aqidah, against all those who innovated in the religion and the deviated sects. He, mashallah, يعني he is the heir or the inheritor of Ibn Taymiyyah's knowledge. Ibn Taymiyyah's knowledge, and if only student for Ibn Taymiyyah is Ibn al-Qayyim, if Ibn Taymiyyah did not produce except Ibn al-Qayyim, that would have been enough for Ibn Taymiyyah, right? That is the state of him. And he was a very soft mannered person, mahbuban عند الناس, and he loved books, bookaholic يعني, loved books, and he had a huge library. And he, subhanAllah, had a very good handwriting. Unlike Ibn Taymiyyah, he did not have a good handwriting, right? Ibn Qayyim had good handwriting. And he had many, many books, mashallah. One of his greatest books, Madarij al-Salikin, to explain only إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. One of his sheikhs, Sheikh al-Islam, Sheikh al-Harawi, and he is the sheikh of one of the shuyukh of Ibn al-Qayyim, and he made a book Manazil al-Sa'irin to see the stages of those who believe in Iyaka na'budu wa Iyaka nasta'in, and he make 100 stages. Your relationship with Allah, how close you are to Allah, is 100 different levels, and with each level there are 3 sub levels. All right, so Ibn al-Qayyim came and he abridged that one, Madarij al-Salikin, in three nice volumes. Maybe Allah give us life one time to explain this book over here, inshallah. So Madarij al-Salikin, and I have ijaza in it from my Sheikh Walid Idris in Minnesota, alhamdulillah. He Sheikh explained the whole book. So Ibn al-Qayyim make that Madarij al-Salikin. He also made a book called I'lam al-Muwaqqi'in, the signers on behalf of Allah, means the scholars. Yeah, those scholars, he is the one who came up with that title. He said the scholar is like someone who signs the fatwas or the verdicts from Allah. He is the one who have the ability to say Allah wants you to do such and such. That's a big responsibility. It can lead to highest degree in Jannah or the lowest degree in fire. يعني, there is nothing in the middle. Okay, so اعلام الموقعين عن رب العالمين. يعني, you know, he is showing those. And he made many books about qada and qadar, and books about dua, and books about the heart, and the books about the newborn babies. أحكام يعني تحفة المولود بأحكام المولود. All the أحكام of the newborn, from pregnancy until, you know, the child, you know, is weaned, and all of that. How to do this? مفتاح دار السعادة for the day of the زاد المعاد في هدي خير العباد. يعني that book is only about the hadi of Rasulullah in everything. What did Rasulullah do in everything? In everything, the names of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the kunyas, the children, the wives, how he used to drink, how he used to eat, how he used to use the restroom, how everything. يعني هدي الرسول in everything. How would Rasulullah do such and such? You fill the gap, and he made that book, subhanallah. And he have the al-kafiya al-shafiya, or what is known as النونية, نونية ابن القيم, and this is a poem in عقيدة, but 3,000 يعني lines in عقيدة, about the عقيدة of the believer, from believing in Allah until you are in Jannah, and how the مؤمنين are enjoying in Jannah. Somebody to write all of this, that means he knows all the hadith and ayat and everything relating to it. So ابن القيم يعني wrote many books, ما شاء الله رب العالمين. And Ibn al-Qayyim was, as I mentioned, the great student of Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah. طيب, well, يعني إن شاء الله, anybody who wants more of Ibn al-Qayyim, you can go to just Google him, you know, and you can read, إن شاء الله, about Ibn al-Qayyim. كتاب الأمثال للعلامة Ibn al-Qayyim, the text, إن شاء الله, will say بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين, والصلاة والسلام على خير البرية محمد وآله وصحبه أجمعين. He is saying, after praising, saying in the name of Allah, praising Allah, which is the sunnah to start everything, and salam on Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his household, his companions, and everyone. Then Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah says وقع في القرآن أمثال, يعني القرآن has many parables or examples. The liking of this is like such and such. This picture is like that, or this act is like that picture, right? So he said that لا يعقلها وإن أمثال القرآن لا يعقلها إلا العالمون. يعني the examples or the parables of the Quran, not any person can understand it or decipher it, except you have to have knowledge. Except you have to have knowledge. That's one of the reasons we are studying this together. Now, ما يعقل العالمون. وأنها, يعني what is أمثال means, شبيه شيء بشيء في حكمه وتقريب المعقول من المحسوس أو أحد المحسوسين من الآخر واعتبار أحدهما بالآخر. He's saying that it is drawing an analogy between two things, right? Or giving you an idea to understand another concept, or giving you a picture to understand another concept. Sometimes it is a physical thing, sometimes it's not a physical thing. So you just try to get it. And then he started giving the examples. كما كقوله تعالى في حق المنافقين, as Allah عز وجل says about the hypocrites in Quran, ومثلهم كمثل الذي استوقد نارا. The first example in Surah Al-Baqarah, the example of those hypocrites, like the example of somebody sought to light a fire. كمثل الذي استوقد نارا. Once he succeeded in gathering the wood and everything, and this استوقد here, it is not مثلهم كمثل الذي أوقد نارا. Allah said استوقد. استوقد يعني طلب الوقود. يعني the one, he made an effort to make a fire. Not أوقدا, أوقدا means he light the fire. But استوقدا, he's looking how do I make the fire, the wood, and put the wood, means he made an effort, right? استوقدا نارا. فلما أضاءت ما حوله, the fire now is like lighting everything. ذهب الله بنورهم. The fire went off suddenly. وتركهم في ظلمات لا يبصرون. They are not seeing the darkness that they cannot see. Not only that, صمم بكمم عميون. When somebody is lost in the desert and in the cold and in the rain and there is no fire, right? And they cannot see anything. So they are like, can I hear somebody to save me? No, they cannot hear because they are summun. Okay, if they cannot hear it, they will say, help, SOS, you know, help me. No, they are bukmun. And they cannot see anything, عميون. Right? So what is the example here of the munafiqeen? Means there was an effort to learn the Quran, to learn the Islam, to learn the deen, to learn the hadith. And then when it started lighting their life and telling them halal and haram and what to do, this hypocrisy and the shirk with Allah Azza Jal, or hatred to Rasulullah, hatred to Islam, it is like that person in the fire and the nothing. And they will not see anything, nothing will get through them because their heart is full of ghil. Is full of hiqd, grudge, envy, covetousness. They hate the deen of Allah. They will not listen, they will not see, they will not talk properly. You get the example now? Yeah, so this is how you draw the example. Or what I said now was not written in the Quran. The Quran is saying their example is like that. And it leave you to how? You know how? How you think? This picture is like the munafiqeen. So now this guy is trying to light the fire. So where the fire fits in the hypocrite? أضاءت ما حوله, that's his life, and this is the iman. And then ذهب الله بنورهم. Why? Because the hypocrisy. This is what destroyed that. It's like that destroyed the fire. You get the idea, right? That is الأمثال في القرآن. أو كصيب من السماء فيه ظلمات ورعد وبرق. Like rain coming, but that rain is not only rain. فيه ظلمات, darkness, it's at night. ورعد, thunder. وبرق, lightning. So lightning has a, it scares you, right? In the visual scare. And thunder, you know, it is an audio scare. You wake up from, you think that something is going to collapse, right? ورق يجعلون أصابعهم في أذانهم من الصواعق حذر الموت. They are afraid that this powerful sound, it will rupture their ear and it will make their head explode and they will die. والله محيط بالكافرين. That shows you the state of the منافقين. Also, that they are scared, that they are afraid. يحسبون كل صيحة عليهم. Every sound they think this is their destruction, because inside they know that they are wrong, right? So Ibn al-Qayyim is giving us that example to show us. So he says, فَضَرَبَ لِلْمُنَافِقِينَ بِحَسَبِ حَالِهِمْ أو بِحَسْبِ حَالِهِمْ, according to their state. يعني their state is like they accepted Iman first or they did not accept Iman. They did like this or they are like that. But then Ibn al-Qayyim giving us a beautiful touch. He said, فَضَرَبَ لِلْمُنَافِقِينَ بِحَسْبِ حَالِهِمْ مَثَلَيْنِ. Those are two examples. مَثَلًا نَارِيًا وَمَثَلًا مَائِيًا. One example, one parable with fire, one parable with water. Why? Because both fire and water, they have benefit. From water, everything is alive, but water can drown you too. And fire can light for you and everything, but fire can burn you too, right? So, you know, the benefit in them. مِنَ الْإِضَاءَةِ وَالْإِشْرَاقِ وَالْحَيَاةِ. All of this lightning and brightness and all that. Because the fire, فَإِنَّ النَّارَ مَادَّةُ النُّورِ. Light comes from the fire. وَالْمَاءُ مَادَّةُ الْحَيَاةِ. The life comes from the water. So one gives you life and one gives you how to manage your life. Alright? So that's why Allah Azza wa Jalla used this example. وَقَدْ جَعْلَ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ الْوَحِي. Allah made the wahi, Ibn al-Qayyim says, الَّذِي أَنزَلَ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ. That it comes from heaven. Water from heaven. Wahi from heaven. Fire, lightning things, wahi, following the sharia, lighting, you see. الَّذِي أَنزَلَ مُتَضَمِّنًا لِحَيَاةِ الْقُلُوبِ وَاسْتِنَارَتِهَا وَلِذَلِكَ سَمَّاهُ رُوحًا وَنُورًا. Allah Azza wa Jalla made this wahi coming from the heaven. It has everything to make your heart alive, like the water makes your body alive. So the wahi makes your heart also alive, because a person can be alive but his heart is dead. And a person can be very sick but his heart is alive. Okay, that's why Allah Azza wa Jal called Al-Quran Ruh. وَكَذَلِكَ أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ رُوحًا مِنْ أَمْرِنَا قَدْ جَاءَكُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ نُورٌ وَكِتَابٌ. So Allah called Quran Ruh, like water is life, Quran is same. Allah called it Nur, like the fire lights you, that lights your way. Quran also lights your heart. As-salam. See how the ulama, you know, capture this. Then Allah Azza wa Jalla said, وَجَعَلَ قَابِلِيهِ أَحْيَاءَ فِي النُّورِ. يعني those who receive this light, Allah Azza wa Jalla make them alive with that light. And whoever does not accept it, they are dead in the darkness. So you are alive in the light, and the other person is dead in the darkness. Okay? So Allah Azza wa Jalla made the Quran and the people who take it like that. And then he says, and Allah Azza wa Jalla, he showed us the situation of the hypocrites and how much they took from the revelation and how they reacted and interacted with it. That they are like the one who light the fire and all of that, because they entered the Islam. So those who did not enter Islam, that example doesn't apply. This example applies to those who entered Islam, took Islam. Islam was introduced to them like that person light the fire. فَاسْتَضَاءُوا بِهِ وَانْتَفَعُوا بِهِ. يعني they actually benefited from it. But then they left it, so the fire extinguished and the Iman also left them. And Allah Azza wa Jalla said, this is the Ibn al-Qayyim saying that this is the example of the person who saw things, then became blind, who knew things, then he denied them. Those who entered Islam, then they exited from it with their heart. They will never come back to it. فَهُمْ لَا يَرْجِعُونَ. You got the example, right? ثُمَّ ذَكَرَ حَلَوْمْ بِالنِّسْبَةِ إِلَى الْمَثَلِ الْمَائِ. Then he gave the example of the rain. صَيِّبْ أَوْ كَصَيِّبْ. صَيِّبْ from صَوَّبَ means target. صَوَّبَ means you toward the target. So this water is targeting earth. That's why it's called صَيِّبْ. صَيِّبْ means it's coming to this land. Rain will happen in this area. كَأُكَ صَيِّبٍ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ. It has darkness, it has lightning, it has thunder and lightning because the lightning here and the thunder, Ibn al-Qayyim says, is like the orders of the Qur'an. It is so hard for them, it became scary for them. Someone whose heart is weak, whenever you say, Allah says you have to pray five times a day, five is not two. Right? Ya akhi, you have to dress like this. My sister, you have to go. Scared. Is Ibn al-Qayyim saying the examples of the Quran and the orders of Allah Azza wa Jalla become so scary, like lightning to their eyes and thunder to their ear. So it is like that, subhanallah. Because if they are scared, what they do? They put their finger in their ears. They don't want to hear it. They don't want to know. I don't want to come to the masjid and learn more. Because if I learn more, it's scary, man. This Islam is very powerful and strong and too much. Right? But you don't know that. If you have a chance to learn and you reject it, you become among the dhaleen. And if you have a chance to learn and you not follow it, you become among the maghdubi alayhim. So there is no option except to seek the knowledge and ask Allah to help us and ask Allah to forgive our shortcomings. But just keep sailing. Don't say, I'm not going to sail because it comes with the responsibility. No, you have to take the responsibility. Now, so Sheikh Imam Ibn al-Qayyim, he is saying, and we saw this among the many of the mubtada'a. I'm not going to go through this because I told you it's very brief. So he said many of those who deviated in the deen and started interpreting the sifat of Allah, and they are saying, you know, this qadr, you know, nobody can do anything, it's no choices and all of that. He said, we see them, they are like that. They don't want to follow, and they use qadr as excuse, right? They don't want to follow that, and they are away from it. And he says, whenever they hear the Quran and the hadith of Rasulullah, كأنهم حمر مستنفرة فرت من قسورة. He said they are like the zebras or the donkeys running away from the lion, right? They are like that. But the believers, they come towards the deen of Allah Azza wa Jal. But the munafiqeen, they run away from any good thing in the deen because it will hold them responsible. And he said that they are running like this. Even though the water has life, he says, because of their shirk, because of their disbelief and association, their hearts become disgusted or rejecting to the deen of Allah. وَإِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهُ وَحْدَهُ شْمَأَزَّتْ قُلُوبُ الَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْآخِرَةِ. Their hearts like hard, you know. وَإِذَا ذُكِرَ الَّذِينَ مِنْ دُونِهِ إِذَا هُمْ يَسْتَبْشِرُونَ. When you talk about the games, about the stars and about things, oh yeah, you know what happened, oh she married, oh he got, she got pregnant and have a child and this love story and all of that, oh good, you know, love. But you know, when the Quran and they say, oh, yeah Shaykh, why you are so tough all the time and hard, like take it easy, man, speak to us about other beautiful stuff. Yeah, be careful, huh? very careful. Then he said, the example Allah gave to them with water, he said, when their hearts became like this, their actions became like that. When hearts become confused, the actions are misguided. When the hearts are confused, the actions are misguided. تَشَابَهَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ تَشَابَهَتْ أَعْمَالُهُمْ. Then he mentioned another section, he said, فَصْلُ, the next section. Allah Azza wa Jal mentioned those two examples, the water and the fire, in Surah Al-Ra'd. Now Ibn al-Qayyim is giving us this concept of a fire example, water example, in the same, dealing with the same. So in Surah Al-Baqarah, dealing with who? Munafiqeen, right? Hypocrites. Give us fire and water. In Surah Al-Ra'd, but in regards to believers, that one with regards to who? Hypocrites. Now the fire and the water will give us example or a parable about who? Mu'mineen. Ah. What did Allah Azza wa Jalla says? فقال تعالى أنزل من السماء ماء. So water coming from heaven. فسالت أودية بقدرها. You have valleys, big valley, small valley, medium valley, X large valley, deep valley, right? كل واد بقدره. But the water filled each one according to its capacity. فسالت أودية بقدرها فاحتمل السيل زبدا رابيا. So this water coming, you find this foam, you know, the white foamy slimy thing on the top. فاحتمل السيل زبدا رابيا ومما يوقدون عليه. That's the water, ومما يوقدون عليه في النار. You know, the fire, you know, the smith putting the gold and the silver and everything inside the fire. Why? To get it pure. So there will impurities will come out. وَمِمَّا يُقِدُونَ عَلَيْهِ فِي النَّارِ بِتِغَاءَ حِلْيَةٍ. To make the bracelets and all of that. أَوْ مَتَاعٍ زَبَدٌ مِثْلُ. There is also this impurity, like the foam coming over the water, the impurity is coming from the fire, because of the metal or because of the minerals. وَمِمَّا يُقِدُونَ عَلَيْهِ بِتِغَاءَ حِلْيَةٍ أَوْ مَتَاعٍ. كَذَلِكَ يَضْرِبُ اللَّهُ الْحَقَّ وَالْبَاطِلِ. So الحق, that water of the rain which is in the valley, البَاطِل is that foam. The الحق is that pure metal coming and the battle is gone by the fire, right? كذلك يضرب الله الحق. فأما الزبد this purity فيذهب جفاء. It goes without count. وأما ما ينفع الناس فيمكث في الأرض. يعني whatever benefit people stays heavy, whether it is water or it is the metal. You see the beauty of the parables of the Quran? Amazing, right? So, شبه الوحي. Allah made the وحي revelation which has the life of the heart, again the life for your ears, for your eyes, like water which comes down and brings all the vegetation and the plants and everything becomes alive. And Allah make the hearts like the valleys. So like the valley takes the water, your heart takes the what? The wahi. You know, this one grows vegetation, this one grows a'mal, iman, ikhlas, ihsan, muraqaba, you know, all of these good things like the plants. And each one according to their sincerity and according to their eagerness, that plant will be stronger, will fruitful, will sour, will sweet, will, you know, everybody have according to their, now. That's exactly like the guidance and the knowledge of Ibn al-Qayyim says, when they mix with the heart, it takes away all the lusts and all the doubts, like the fire burns that impurities out, and like that foam flows away from that valley. He says, you know, when your heart is full of ilm and the hidayah, it will negate and all take away all these impurities, like that fire takes away the impurities from that gold, mashallah. Also, he's saying something important, Ibn al-Qayyim. He says, medicine. When you take the medicine, sometimes it will upset your stomach. Dr. Hasib is here, can tell us. It can upset your stomach. It can make you have a reaction. But why is that reaction? A doctor will tell you, that means it's working. It is working. So the medicine goes, and then you start feeling the fever and start feeling your body is reacting, but the doctor said that's okay because the body is working now. So he's saying sometimes the ilm and guidance of Allah is that hard. It changes your life. That's why I tell people sometimes, somebody who's not practicing, a husband or a wife or both, and they start being practicing, then they'll have all types of problems. Then they come to the office, I was doing okay. Once I became practicing and I come to the masjid, now I have trouble, you know, everything. I'm out of the job and I'm this, and my parents said, I said, of course, this is the trade. This is what's supposed to happen, actually, right? So that's, it happens like this. But then if you are solid, if you are strong, if you are pure, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, you are going to get there. If not in the dunya, in the akhirah, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. So he's saying that that's how medicine works, that's how knowledge works, that's how Quran works. Too many things to do. Do this, do this, do this, sunnah, this, sunnah, that. And once you do the fard, you get to the arena of the sunnah. Once you finish the sunnah, you get to the arena of the mustahab. Then once you get to the mustahab, means preferable, so you do fard. Oh, alhamdulillah, I'm done the fard. But then the sunnah, you know? And now I want to do the sunnah. Finish the sunnah, oh, liked, things liked. And then you find it, you know, you are supposed to do the best. And you are supposed to abandon many of the good things just because you want to be in the top. Keep going like this. And Ibn al-Qayyim mentioning that's how Allah Azza Jal make the life, you know, the example of the fire and the example of the water. He said that's exactly the lust and the doubts. The heart of the believer will get it out with that light, that fire of iman, with that water of wahi, right? Water of wahi will come and make your heart have sincerity, have piety, have righteousness. And the fire of the nur of the ilm, like the light of the fire, will burn away all the desire and the lusts and all of that, and make your heart very, very pure. Then he mentioned another example. Before that he said, وَمَنْ لَمْ يَفْقَهْ هَذَيْنِ الْمَثَلَيْنِ, those two parables we mentioned, Baqarah for Munafiqeen and Ra'd for the Mu'mineen, he said, whoever does not understand this well, وَلَمْ يَتَدَبَّرْهُمَا, and does not ponder upon them, وَيَعْرِفُ مَا يُرَادُ مِنْهُمَا, and does not know what is required and acts upon it, فَلَيْسَ مِنْ أَهْلِهِمَا, he will not be, surely he will not be among those. To avoid the nifaq and to get the iman, he will be confused. So that he is emphasizing here on what? Every Muslim should learn those. That's what he's saying. Otherwise, you stay confused. You'll be saved if you can imitate someone nice. You'll be good. But what if that person is not there? Right? So this is very important. Faslun, an example after that, he says, وَمِنْهَا, and among those parables and examples that Allah gave, he said, مِنْهَا قَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى, the example of Allah Azza wa Jalla, إِنَّمَا مَثَلُ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا, the example of this life, حَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا, كَمَاءٍ, again water, كَمَاءٍ أَنْزَلْنَاهُ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ, we came brought down from the sky, فَاخْتَلَطَ بِهِ نَبَاتُ الْأَرْضِ, mixed with the vegetation of this earth, مِمَّا يَأْكُلُ النَّاسِ وَالْأَنْعَامِ, يعني this, the vegetation has part for humans, vegetables and fruits and corn and grain and all that, والأنعام, grass and you know other things, يأكلون أسوأ الأنعام, حتى إذا أخذت الأرض زخرفها وزينت, until earth takes its complete adornment and it becomes lush and beautiful, lush and beautiful, وظن أهلها أنهم قادرون عليها, and its residents, the people who are living, they think that they are in control of earth now. Imagine now science, for example, will come and say, you know what, we can make artificial clouds, artificial rain, and we can control the weather, and we can control the heat of the sun, and we can do over all, maybe one day it will come. Allah said, one day people will think that they are in control of earth. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, when that happens, أتاها أمرنا ليلا أو نهارا, a day or a night will come, one order, one second, like a blink of an eye. You know what's going to happen the next day? Whoever looks at it will not even imagine that there was something called earth. فجعلناها حصيدا, leveled, كأن لم تغن بالأمس, as it did not exist yesterday. يعني nobody even will recognize that this destruction happened yesterday. It has been like that forever. Like that. You see no trace of existence of any civilization when the order of Allah comes to earth. كذلك نفصل الآيات, Allah said that's how we detail and explain the آيات, لقوم يتفكرون. So this is, now you have to think and ponder. May Allah make us among those يتفكرون. So Allah Azza wa Jal make this life and whatever in it, the example of that is like what? What is the parable here? What is the parable? That the dunya is adorning itself. And who adorns themselves? Women. A bride in the night of her wedding, right? She looks, she put the makeup and do all of these things, and the dunya for its residents, men and women, all that, it is like that. It's like that example. تأخذ زينة يعني, to attract you and behind it, run behind it. So his heart will go towards it. And now he's not seeing anything except that subject, that it is adorned and looking beautiful and pretty. And he thinks once he thinks that he can grab, right? And now in control, it will abandon, will leave. Either you'll be taken away from it will be taken away from you. Either or. But it will not be in your hand. Because dunya, either it will leave you or you will leave it. You know, when was asked, what is the dunya? He said, it is like dhillu shajara. It is like the shade of a tree. And you are traveling, you will sit in it. Either you will stand up and continue, or the shade will move because of the sun. So one of the two, the shade will go away from you, or you will go away from the shade. But you are not going to stay forever. Except with dhill of Jannah. Dhillan, dhalila, that's another story in the Jannah. Dhill means shade. So Allah Azza wa Jalla made the dunya like that. And when he needed the most, when he became addicted to it, it is gone. Like Allah Azza wa Jalla said, when they became able to on the earth, it is gone. Now, subhanallah. Allah, Imam Ibn al-Qayyim saying, rahimahullah, so when the dunya is like that, is subject to all these diseases and all these problems, and it is never permanent and all of that, and the Jannah is the Jannah of permanent residence, the place of eternity, Allah Azza wa Jalla says what in the Quran? He's saying, see that example is here about the dunya, right? But what did Allah say about the Jannah? وَاللَّهُ يَدْعُو إِلَىٰ دَارِ السَّلَامِ, Allah is inviting you to it. So what you get here as aqil, as a sane person, when he says dunya is like that, and I invite you to go to Jannah, what does that mean? Use this to get there. This is not important compared to that. This is nothing and this is everything. Right? وَاللَّهُ يَدْعُوا إِلَى دَارِ السَّلَامِ. Why Allah call it دار السلام? Imam Ibn al-Qayyim says, لِسَلَامَتِهَا مِنَ هَذِهِ الْآفَاتِ. Salam means safety and means perfection also. Means it's سَالِمَةٌ مِنَ الْآفَاتِ. You know when you slaughter the qurbani, يعني بكري عيد, you know في عيد الأضحى, you slaughter the qurbani, it has to be one of the condition, سَلِيمَةٌ مِنَ الْآفَاتِ. يعني سلام means does not have any defect. فالجنة دار السلام means the dar of no defect, no shortcoming. دار السلام. Next, he says, مثل الفريقين. Another example, Ibn al-Qayyim mentioning. مثل الفريقين. Allah عز وجل says in Surah Hud, مثل الفريقين كالأعمى والأصم. Like the blind and the deaf. والسميع والبصير والسميع. And the person who's seeing, person who's hearing. So you have two categories, right? Either one person here and one person here, or two people here and two people here. The ayah can be understood both ways, right? مثل الفريقين, you have two teams. كالأعمى والأصم, you can say one blind and one deaf, or one guy who's blind and deaf. والسميع والبصير والسميع, and one person seeing good and one person hearing good, both of have hearing and ear, or one person has both, which is more, you know, proper here. هل يستويان مثلا? Question. If you have two teams and they're going to play basketball and you have like mashallah brother Hakim al-Ajwan and Michael Jordan in one team, and you have like, you know, Sheikh Mamdouh and someone who never played basketball in the other team, يعني. And yalla, play five, you know, whatever. هل يستويان? You look at it and say, what are you trying to do? That's common sense, right? It doesn't work like that. If you bring one from this team here, that's fine. It can work like that, right? But no, opposite. هل يستويان? Subhanallah. So of course, أفلا تذكرون? Don't you remember? So Allah Azza wa Jal here, Ibn al-Qayyim says, he mentioned the kuffar and he, the non-believer, and he described them that they cannot hear, they cannot see the truth. That means they can see physically, but they're not seeing the wisdom behind it. They're not hearing the message. They can hear Quran and even they can quote it. Okay, they can quote it, but they don't listen to it. They're not listening to the message. Then Allah mentioned the mu'mineen. So those two teams is like the believer and the non-believer, right? They both have eyes and they both have ears. But a group choose to be blind and deaf, and a group choose to use and utilize the ni'mah that Allah gave them to reach the haqq. So he said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them the ubudiyyah, I mean the slavery, the servitude of the believer is to Allah externally and internally. Where is that? أعمى وأصم وبصير وسميع. It's all internal, right? Where is the internal? The internal is sometimes when you tell the person, aren't you seeing what is happening here? You are not talking about something physical. You know, whoever does not see what is going on in this room is a blind person. The dynamics, huh? The person who is shouting all the time and the person who is putting his head down. And he's saying, do you see what's happening here? Yeah, I'm seeing someone shouting. But do you see the humiliation? Do you see the arrogance of that guy? This is what I'm asking you to see. If you don't see it, you're blind. You understand now the internal, right? External is physical. Big guy, small guy, one is, you know. So Ibn Qayyim saying, عِبَادَ الظَّهْرَ وَعِبَادَ بَاطِنَ. So the kafir does not want to internalize, does not want to reflect on the message. Hence, will not be praying, fasting, or doing anything externally. The believer is doing the opposite. Accepts the iman in the heart, so they love Allah and they pray. They want to hear the words of Allah and they recite the Quran. You see? So this is what he is mentioning. So he says, blindness can be for the heart, like the blindness of the eye. Seeing, it can be for the heart, like the seeing of the eye. Deafness can be also of the heart and the soul like that of the ear. هل يستويان مثلا؟ Of course not. Then Ibn al-Qayyim mentioned another one. He says ومنها قولي تعالى the example also of parables of the Quran. مثل الذين اتخذوا من دون الله أولياء the example of those who took protectors or guardians or friends other than Allah. Lower. من دون الله. You see the word من دوني? دون يعني under. So they know it's under but they're still taking them as equal to Allah. مثل الذين اتخذوا من دون الله أولياء كمثل العنكبوت. The example is like a spider. اتخذت بيتا the female spider يعني. It took a house, made a house. فذكر يعني الله عز وجل mentioned that they are weak. They are in themselves weak. And they took protectors weaker than them. يعني a spider you can step on and you can crush يعني, right? And it takes the house, that web is weaker than the spider itself. يعني because the spider is hunting other animals, other insects with it, right? But they are saying, it's like you are a spider and you are using your house, which wind can blow in it and can do all of that. So they are not helping you much. Even if it helps the spider, it's temporary. It is not as strong. وَإِنَّ أَوْهَنَ الْبُيُوتِ The weakest of houses is the house of Al-Ankabut, if they only know. Allah Azza wa Jal says in the Quran, Ibn al-Qayyim mentioning that ayah, وَاتَّخَذُوا مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ آلِهَةً They took gods other than Allah, لِيَكُونُوا لَهُمْ عِزَّةً To increase their dignity. كَلَّا سَيَكْفُرُونَ بِعِبَادَتِهِمْ وَيَكُونُونَ عَلَيْهِمْ ضِدَّةً يعني they will be opposite to them. So put ayat together, it will give you that. وَاتَّخَذُوا مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ آلِهَةً Why? They took Aliha beside Allah, gods beside Allah. لَعَلَّهُمْ يُنصَرُونَ You know, so they can give them victory. لَا يَسْتَطِيعُونَ نَصْرَهُمْ وَهُمْ لَهُمْ جُنْدٌ مُحْضَرُونَ So ayah in Yasin, and ayah in Surah Taha, and the ayah in Surah Al-Ankabut, they all complement each other to show you the weakness of whom they take as protectors under Allah, below Allah, Azza wa Jal. وَقَالَ بَعْدَ أَنْ ذَكَرَ هَلَكَ الْأُمَمِ الْمُشْرِكِينَ Allah Azza wa Jalla says, Imam Al-Qayyim says, and after Allah Azza wa Jalla said, after he demolished all the nations of the polytheists, وَمَا ظَلَمْنَاهُمْ We have not transgressed them, وَلَكِنْ ظَلَمُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ They transgressed themselves. Why? By taking the gods, right? By taking those to worship beside Allah. فَمَا أَغْنَتْ عَنْهُمْ آلِهَتُهُمُ الَّتِي يَدْعُونَ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ مِنْ شَيْءٍ These gods that they You say, oh, please bring us rain, please bring us. When the azab of Allah comes, what these gods would do? Nothing. مَا أَغْنَتْ عَنْهُمْ آلِهَتُهُمْ Their gods, الَّتِي يَدْعُونَ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ That they are calling beside Allah or below Allah. مِنْ شَيْءٍ It did not help them from anything. لَمَّا جَاءَ أَمْرُ رَبِّكَ يعني when the order of Allah comes, they're not going to help them. Actually, وَمَا زَادُوهُمْ غَيْرَ تَتْبِيبٍ تَبَّتْ يَدَ أَبِي لَهَبٍ يعني. تب means more destruction يعني more suffering more misery you know when you think something is going to help you it ends up being against you mashallah you are carrying a big huge machine computer or something like that you think it's going to help you and all of this okay so you go to the airport or you go somewhere you want it to work doesn't work battery is gone no charger And now you're going to carry all this 20 pounds with you. right? Because you don't want to throw it. So you cannot use it and you're going to throw it and you have to carry it. وَمَا زَادُوهُمْ غَيْرَ تَتْبِيب يعني only increase their suffering. Increase their suffering. You know, وَلَا يَحْمِلُنَّ أَوْزَارَهُمْ وَأَوْزَارًا مَعَ أَوْزَارِهِمْ لَحْمِلُنَّ أَثْقَالَهُمْ وَأَثْقَالًا مَعَ أَثْقَالِهِمْ يعني they carry their heavy weights and the weights of others. So he said Ibn al-Qayyim فَهَذِهِ أَرْبَعَةُ مَوَاضِعٍ InshaAllah we'll finish with that هَذِهِ أَرْبَعَةُ مَوَاضِعٍ Those are four places He gave us the example of the hypocrites Two examples البقرة water and fire He gave us the example of the believers The water and the fire in the valley And the fire in the you know For the gold and the silver For the believers Then he gave us the example of this dunya it is like the rain and all of that, and it will be wiped out like it did not exist. And then he gave us the example of the mushrikeen taking other than Allah, like the spider web. You see four examples now, right? Munafiqeen, mu'mineen, making the dunya, and shirk with Allah is like the spider web. Four, huh? فهذه أربعة مواضع. Those are four places in the Quran. تدل على أن من اتخذ من دون الله وليا. Those who take a wali other than Allah عز وجل, friend, close guardian to Allah, advisor other than Allah. يتعزز به, to seek dignity with. ويستكثر به, to seek number with. ويستنصر به, to seek victory with. لم يحصل له به إلا ضد مقصوده. يعني he will gain nothing except the opposite of what he wishes. Remember that. When you go, when a person goes away from the path of Allah thinking that they will succeed, what they will get? Failure. When you go to the path of Allah, even by the standard of this world you are suffering, you get victory. Victory. Remember that. So it's all about changing those concepts. And he said, في القرآن أكثر من ذلك. In Quran there are more than that. وهذا من أحسن الأمثال وأدلها على بطلان الشرك وخسارة صاحبه وحصوله على ضد مقصوده. This is the best proof or the best four examples that he chose for us in his book to show us, to summarize all this world is about that. Don't commit shirk, you become like that. And if you get the iman, hold to it and get all the impurities out. Otherwise you end like munafiqeen. You see why he put them together? To give you the structure of everything. The dunya, believing in other than Allah, hypocrisy, and faith. So you put all the examples and you choose the one that is good and you avoid the one which is bad. He says, if people say that they know that the weakest of houses or weakest of residence is the residence or the place of the spider web. Why Allah عز وجل said, لو كانوا يعلمون, means they don't know. They know that. They know that it's weak. So why Allah عز وجل said, they don't know. So he said, Ibn al-Qayyim said, Allah is not negating their knowledge. Allah عز وجل is negating that they don't know the example. They don't know what they are doing is like the spider web. He's not saying, لو كانوا يعلمون, because someone knows Arabic, he will say that وَإِنَّ أَوْهَانَ الْبُيُوتُ لَبَيْتُ الْعَنْكَبُوتِ لَوْ كَانُوا يَعْلَمُونَ, means the weakest is the spider web, but they don't know that, the word that. If you put that in the translation, means they don't know that the weakest is the spider web. They said, no, but we know. So Allah is not saying that you don't know, no, you don't know the relationship. You don't know that what you're doing is like that. That is the part that you don't know. لَوْ كَانُوا يعلمون. That's why he said, وَمَا يَعْقِلُهَا إِلَّا الْعَالِمُونَ. Only those who have knowledge are the ones who realize that. So we'll stop here inshallah, and the next time بإذن الله تعالى we will continue with the example of the person who sees a mirage while he's very thirsty, what it is like, and we will continue with it inshallah. May Allah Azza wa Jal make us among those who listen and follow the best of what they listen to. وصلى اللهم وسلم وبارك على سيدنا ونبينا وحبيبنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم والحمد لله رب العالمين.